Let's begin the session. Endoplasmic reticulum. It is large network of membrane bound tubes and sheets. It looks like long tubules and round or oblong bags called vesicles. You can see here in this picture membrane bound tubes and sheets. Okay, now here you can see round or oblong vesicles. Okay, so this is the structure of endoplasmic reticulum. Now, endoplasmic reticulum is of two types: rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Here you can see in this picture this part is rough endoplasmic reticulum. You can see here ribosomes are attached to the surface of this endoplasmic reticulum. So this one has a rough surface, so it is called rough endoplasmic reticulum. When observed under microscope, its surface is rough. Now, coming to the another type, this is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. This one, okay, you can see ribosomes are not attached here, so this is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So the structural difference is rough endoplasmic reticulum has ribosomes on its surface, whereas smooth endoplasmic reticulum do not have ribosomes on its surface. Okay, now rough endoplasmic reticulum is extensive and continuous with the outer membrane of the nucleus. Yes, you can see in this picture it is extensive when compared with the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and also it has connection with the nuclear membrane. The outer membrane of the nucleus is connected with the rough endoplasmic reticulum, and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum is connected with the rough endoplasmic reticulum. So this is how they are seen inside the cell. Now, moving to the next, endoplasmic reticulum serves as channels for protein transport. Okay, as they are the tubular structures distributed inside the cytoplasm, they can transport proteins from one part of the cytoplasm to another part, or between nucleus and cytoplasm, proteins can be exchanged through these channels of endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, and endoplasmic reticulum has important role in membrane biogenesis. It means formation of new membranes. Here, rough endoplasmic reticulum synthesizes proteins, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum synthesizes lipids. Okay, so these proteins and lipids synthesized by the two types of endoplasmic reticulum are useful for the formation of membranes. You have studied in earlier sessions, cell membrane is made up of proteins and lipids. So these proteins and lipids are useful for the formation of cell membrane, and this process is called membrane biogenesis. Okay, now some other proteins and lipids formed in ER function as enzymes and hormones. Okay, so steroid hormones, SER synthesizes steroid hormones. Okay, so these are some of the functions of endoplasmic reticulum. Now, moving to the next, endoplasmic reticulum functions as cytoplasmic framework, and it provides surface for several biochemical activities. Okay, so that is the reason it is okay functioning as a cytoplasmic framework. Okay, it is providing the surface for several biochemical activities in the cell. Now, endoplasmic reticulum also has important role in detoxification of poisons and drugs. This is especially in liver, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum in liver cells play this important role in detoxification of many poisons and drugs. Okay, endoplasmic reticulum divides intracellular space into two distinct compartments. Okay, and they are luminal, okay, compartment, and the second is extraluminal compartment. Okay, so these are the two compartments formed because of ER in the cell. I repeat this point once again. Endoplasmic reticulum divides the intracellular space into two distinct compartments. They are luminal compartment and extraluminal compartment. This extraluminal compartment is nothing but the cytoplasm. And luminal compartment is the region enclosed inside the ER membranes. Okay, so this is about endoplasmic reticulum. Now, moving to the next, after this, Golgi apparatus. Okay, Golgi apparatus is a system of membrane bound vesicles. These vesicles are the flattened sacs arranged in stacks called cisternae. When these vesicles or the flattened sacs are arranged in parallel stacks, okay, then they are called cisternae. And these cisternae have 0.5 to 1 micrometer diameter. Okay, now these membranes often have connections with the membranes of ER, that is endoplasmic reticulum. If you see this in a picture, you can see these are the cisternae. Okay, now here these are the cisternae. They are parallelly arranged. You can see these are the flattened sacs, and they are arranged one upon the other to form stack-like structures, and these are called cisternae. And the diameter inside this cisternae, okay, each cisterna is about 0.52, okay, 1 micrometer diameter. Okay, now here in this structure you will find two surfaces. One is called convex and the other is called concave. Okay, one convex and the other concave. Okay, and these two, they have different names. Convex is also called cis or forming phase. Concave is also called trans or maturing phase. Okay, you can see here this convex is cis or forming phase. Okay, and this one is trans or maturing phase. Okay, so these are the two phases seen in the Golgi apparatus. Okay, now here this Golgi cisternae are concentrically arranged near the nucleus. Okay, so they are concentrically arranged near the nucleus, and these are the two phases that are seen in Golgi apparatus. Okay, the cis and trans phases of the organelle are entirely different, but they are interconnected. Yes, though they are different, they are interconnected. Okay, in the cis side, the vesicles, they are receiving the proteins formed from endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, and through the trans phase, they are released out. Okay, so this is how the Golgi apparatus functions. Okay, now the functions of Golgi apparatus. The material synthesized near the endoplasmic reticulum is packaged and dispatched to various targets inside the cell and outside the cell through Golgi apparatus. Okay, and the storage, modification and package of products in vesicles is the function of Golgi apparatus. Okay, the different proteins, they are stored, they are modified, they are packaged and they are dispatched to various target sites inside the cell and outside the cell through this Golgi apparatus. Now here complex sugars may be made from simple sugars in the Golgi apparatus. This is one more function. Okay, simple sugars are converted into complex sugars, and it is the important site for the formation of glycoproteins, glycolipids. Okay, and here Golgi apparatus also has important role in formation of lysosomes. Okay, now this Golgi complex is discovered by Camillo Golgi. Okay, this scientist, okay, worked on nervous system. Okay, and Camillo Golgi developed a revolutionary method of staining, and that is called black reaction. One of the important concepts, okay, this black reaction is a revolutionary method of staining each nerve and cell structures, and this is particularly useful for tracing the processes or delicate ramifications of the nerve cells. Okay, so for this study, okay, Camillo Golgi received Nobel Prize. Okay, so this is all about endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi apparatus. Okay, I'll be back with another video. Have a great day. Thank you.